ourselves in a position in the first half to come out with a win. And second half kind of unfolded. So we kind of know what could happen if we're not ready to play, and then we know what can happen if we're ready to play.
How like tough is it to deal with their size at just on that front line?
Again, I think it's just about us. I think in the first half we dealt with their size just fine, although they got a couple offensive rebounds that we shouldn't be giving up. But we dealt with it fine in the first half. Like I said, in the second half we just didn't stay with it. So just about pounding. It's just being physical. We know that they're a big team and they got a lot of great front court players. But like we have the guys capable to be able to handle it.
Is it a size that other teams have? Because it seems with those guys that they have three players, whereas like most teams they have two big guys, but they pack it with three big guys who are like 6'9" or taller.
Yeah, I mean, and they're all great players, but I mean, we dealt with the same thing kind of against Gonzaga, and I think we kind of just learned from the games. I think look down in the Pac-12, a lot of teams have a lot of big guys. Even Utah, even though they might not be as good as Arizona's front court, still size is size at the end of the day. So I think we've dealt with it a lot, and especially playing them before, so we should be ready to kind of handle it.
Coach was asked this too, but do you learn more from what you did right against them in the first half or what you did wrong in the second half?
For me, I think what we did wrong in the second half, if I could look at it a little bit more, just because we know how to play right, we know what we're doing when we're playing right, and then when we're playing wrong, it's kind of, well, what do we need to do to get back on track? And for them, they're such a good team, such a great program, that any time we make a couple of mishaps or a couple of bad plays that can capitalize quick, so I think if we focus on trying to limit those, we'll put ourselves in a good position.
Marquis, I know obviously it's common sense to say the longer you can stay in a game, the more productive and the more value you have. But it seems like it could be a hard lesson to learn. Do you feel like that's starting to come home for you now?
Yeah, I talked to Romar at halftime of the last game. He was just telling me like I needed to stay in the game. And I hear it a lot, but he just told me when we were in the locker room that if I can't get it for sure, just don't jump and risk it. And, like get silly fouls and things that like I don't need. Like trying to jump and grab the ball when I'm already boxed out and stuff, like things that are unnecessary.
I think, you know, sometimes during the game you can have sometimes something happens and you almost have a look like you're not even sure. Like sometimes, do you ever get a feeling like maybe the officials are starting to single you out a little bit sometimes?
I wouldn't say that. I just think a foul is a foul. And if you get a foul call, you're not always going to agree with it. And it's like, even if after the game I could admit that I foul, but like during the game, it's like you'll fight to the end of your life to say you didn't foul. So
the sort of agreement you guys have where you're coming out now after your first foul, mm-hmm. You feel like that's helped you at all, or just kind of what's your take on that, how that's gone?
I think it helps our team and me at the same time. It's because I don't want to stay in and get more fouls, but I don't want to also come out because I want to play. But I just think when I come out, it kind of keeps the game going instead of me getting fouls and having to stop the game. I can just come back in and just try to jump back in with my team.
You know, and then just for someone who has to deal with the sort of front hand, how is their size? I mean, just having a big guy in front of you and then you have to sort of switch also maybe to a big guy, just how is that to deal with?
I mean, we play against a lot of good bigs, but they're talented and they can do multiple things and they're strong and physical. But I think our bigs, we don't back down to anybody really. Like, we'll play our hardest against anyone and compete, and if they get the better of us, then that just happens. But we don't really want to back down to anyone.
For either one of you guys, so the way that unfolded in the second half, do you feel like it's just a matter of not being in foul trouble with the bigs and allowing you guys to play the full game with the full complement? Because I know foul trouble obviously was a big factor in that second half.
Yeah, I think when we start getting fouls, our defense kind of backs off a little bit, and we're not as aggressive as we are in the first half. We just have to play a full game of defense, really, and just try to control their tempo and play the way we want to play.
Henry, you've talked about feeding off the home crowd energy. Is there, I don't want to say, danger in maybe relying on that crowd for this game, or the sellout, being too hyped that they're there for you?
I don't think so. It's danger in a sense. I think whenever the building's electric, we're always capable of making a run. I think it's not like we don't bring our own energy, but just having them there makes us that more energetic or that more wanting to make big plays or get a couple stops in a row, get them excited about coming to the games, just having an overall good time. And also, along with that big thing, I think a lot of it is getting overcredited was a lot of their guards had a lot of dribble penetration, made an easy dump off. Cartwright had 11 assists, so it wasn't like their bigs were just getting it down low and just going to work on our bigs or anything like that. A lot of it was because of guard penetration. got in a transition a lot, so give a lot of credit to the guards for getting the bigs going. They weren't just single-handedly just throwing down ice on us and scoring. So,
Marquise, what are your thoughts about the big sellout and buzz in town about your program that's on the rise?
I love it. I like seeing everybody supporting us and that they're coming to watch a good game. But I just think we have to focus on it like any other game and just come out and play our type of basketball.
Yeah, talk to Coach Romar a little bit about the 2004 game against Arizona, and I don't know how much you guys know about that, but have you guys ever seen film of that game, or has they ever talked at all about that game?
When you were being recruited, you know, obviously they were filling this place up regularly, and they sold out. Last time they sold out was during your redshirt year. Does this just feel like you've been waiting a long time for this, and here it is, your fifth year, senior year, and you're finally going to be playing in front of a sellout, and it's a big game, and that kind of thing?
It hasn't really hit home for me yet. I think being in the moment, kind of see things a little bit differently. I'm just ready to play another game, to be honest. I don't really look at the specs of it. I think when I look back at it when the year's over, I'll probably just say, like, wow, and all this other stuff just about the crowd seeing the dog pack back and everything. But for now, I'm just focused on the games.
You talked about dribble penetration, Andrew. With Alonzo Trier, I know you didn't play against him down there, but what you've seen on film, what kind of dimension does he add to that aspect of what they do?
For him, I mean, before he went down, he was their leading scorer. I think even coming back, he still might be their leading scorer on the team. But he just gives him a whole nother look as a dynamic player off the dribble. He can catch and shoot. He can take it. He can iso you. His name's like isolation zone or something like that. Just gives him another great perimeter player. So just got to be ready for if he plays or if he doesn't play. Just knowing that he's a capable and willing scorer and also looks to pass, gets his team involved, just a great player.
Are you guys preparing for him to play, or coaches seem to think he was definitely going to play?
Yeah, we prepare for every situation. We didn't prepare for him last game because he was definitely out, but I think with him being probable or questionable, I think especially him being from Seattle or being from this area, he'll come back and try and play. So got to be ready for everything that comes our way.
In the past, when you've gone through scoring slumps or, you know, the things you did to get out of them were what? And anything that you can sort of take from then that can help you maybe now?
I don't really worry about it. I think scoring is only one part of my game. I think the other night and the last time I haven't been scoring, still did a great job of just being a leader, playing defense, just let the scoring come to me. I think if you try to press the issue or press the matter, only put yourself in a bigger hole. I'm a great scorer, so it's just going to come out of time. Everybody misses shots, so I just try not to worry about it. If I focus on other things, getting the ball, just making the right plays, then I'll be all right.